Hey everybody, it's Moonbo here, and welcome back to more Endless Scrap Mechanic. Today we're going to be hopping into the challenge mode to take a look at ScrapMan's Scrap Golf 9 holes. Now this is a challenge pack, as you can see here. There's a whole bunch of different holes that we're going to have to complete. Now before we can move on to the next hole, we have to complete the hole prior to it. And it really seems like these holes get more and more complicated and difficult as you progress all the way up to the 9th one. And this actually reminds me, guys, I started doing the Master Mechanic Trials. We got to level 10, and I kind of just forgot about it, actually. So this is a good reminder, guys. I'm gonna have to pick up on that one as well and finish the basic challenges. Now, I don't know if you guys know this about me, but I do love golf. I've been playing it since I was about 12 years old, and I was actually just playing mini golf yesterday. So hopefully that has warmed me up for this challenge. Now, I'm really excited to check this out, guys. So let's see it. Alright, so here we are, hole number one of the Scrap Golf Challenge. Now, I'm thinking, guys, there must be some type of rule set, right? Now, I know Khan, he might not have been following the rules, and I think he might have made it a little easier for himself, but I'm thinking we're not going to want to hit this ball more than once while it's moving, right? So here we go, let's try this out. First hit. Okay, keep going, come on, keep going, keep going, keep rolling. Is it going to make it? Hole in one? Come on. Yeah, hole in one. Jeez, that wasn't too bad. So I guess we're gonna be moving on to hole number two. All right, so here we are, hole number two. Now let's just get a quick look here. I don't even know what to expect. So we're gonna go up and down this little L-shaped thing here. Okay, and then we just go into the hole there. That's not too bad. All right, so I'm thinking I'm going to want to cut that angle right there, right? If we kind of get as close to that wall as we can, maybe just hit it right in the center here. And I want it to just roll up next to the corner here. Is it going to go? Come on. Perfect. So now that's exactly what I wanted to do. Now I'm going to try and do the exact same thing on this corner right here. Maybe give it a little bit of side spin too. Okay, I went a little bit wide there. But I think we have our shot. Yes, we do. We got a final shot right here. Right into the hole. Maybe somewhere right about there. And perfect. All right, now this is hole number three. Now look at this, guys. We've got the trademark windmill. You guys know it's not mini golf if there is no windmill. Now let's see here. This might be a little tricky. I don't know if there's much timing in this. I can't even see past the ball. Guys, this is not mini golf. This is jumbo golf. So I'm just gonna hope for the best here. Oh, come on now. What's gonna happen? Oh, and it got denied. Oh, come on. Where are you going? All right, I'm gonna time it. After the next one, right there. Oh no, I hit it too soon. All right, we're gonna have to try this again, but now I am even farther away, so I'm just gonna see here. We're gonna wait for that one to go. There we go. Perfect, made it through. We're going to the left side here. Oh, this is awesome, guys. This is a lot like mini golf. All right, so I think I'm gonna wanna actually go straight down this line right there to that edge, and I don't wanna go too far, so we're gonna hit it a little bit lower. There we go, nice and gentle. Was it enough to get around? Okay, I might have been able to hit that just a little bit harder here. Maybe I'm gonna have to like hit the near bottom like that. No, yeah, that was perfect spin. There we go. And just stop right about there. And I think we should be able to just give it a gentle hit. And there we go. All right, here we are at hole number four, I do believe. Now, this is interesting, actually. We're gonna be dropping down there. And this is a very narrow little path here, so wish me luck, guys. All right, we're gonna line it up right about here, and I think I'm just gonna give it full-on top spin. There we go. All right, stay on. Okay, perfect. So okay, wait, it went into that. Oh look, it spawned another one underneath it. What? Oh, there's a ball spawner there. That's pretty neat. And look, it set us up exactly where we need to be. Now what is this? This is like a jump. Okay, it's a jump, and then the hole is over there around the corner. Okay, let's see here. I don't want to hit it too hard from here. I don't know. Actually, you know what? Maybe I might be able to get enough speed from back here. I don't know if I want to do that or not. You know what? I'm going to set myself up here. We're going to just set it up right in front of the ramp like so. Yes, please don't fall off the edge. Oh my god, that was so close. All right. We've set ourselves up for our next shot. So I'm thinking we're gonna wanna go like to the left a little bit, like this, over. Oh, perfect. All right, look at this. We have an invisible bridge. That's pretty cool. Oh wow, look at this, it's actually rolling towards the hole, what? Okay, I'm pretty proud of that last shot, guys. Alright, now this seems pretty straightforward, we're just gonna hit it directly into the hole. Wait a second, look at this, guys, there's like flat edges on these balls. These balls don't make any sense here, I feel like they wouldn't roll as well as they should. Alright, we're just gonna hit it right there, smack it into the hole, beauty! Alright, so now we are on hole number 5, I think, and now this is the, like, Egyptian pyramid-style hole. Wow, it looks really cool. This is like an upgrade from the last hole, guys. We got this narrow little, like, tightrope that we have to go through, and then we're gonna be dropping down into that hole there. So, I think as long as we just kind of hit it square, center, and we line ourselves up on this, like, center line right here, we should be alright. So I'm gonna go right about here. And we're gonna want some of that top spin on it too, so there we go. Right across the beam, down the hole we go. And what the heck is this? Why is this just here in the way for the sake of being in the way? And what? Why is there a seat here? Okay, that's good to know. So we're gonna have to set up for whatever the heck is going on there. We've got some type of MXC style spinning thing. Alright, we're gonna hit that, bounce it off. Please, right where I need it. Oh, come on. Is that good? Okay, I think there's enough clearance for us to get across that. So we need to really focus on our line here. I'm thinking, oh, this is actually a good technique, guys. If you ever do this, just jump and you'll see where you're lining up here. So I'm thinking we're gonna want right about there. Uh-oh, I moved my thing. Okay, we're gonna wait for the next one. Right there. Across. Oh, come on, I didn't do it soon enough. So very sadly, guys, I have found out what this seat is for, and it's actually so you can go back and start over again. It's the shame seat, guys. It's the shame seat. All right, so we managed to go out of bounds. Guys, it's mini golf. What the heck? There's not supposed to be any out of bounds whatsoever, but we're gonna try this again, and hopefully this time I'm gonna time it a little bit better. So there we go. We're going across the tightrope into the pyramid, down the other side, and I'm gonna do the same thing as last time. We're gonna bank it off of that wall there, get a decent bounce into this little channel, and here we go. So now I'm gonna line this up, and right now. Yes, we did it! Now, am I supposed to cross this bridge too? Alright, I gotta make it across safely as well, apparently. And whoa, it's still going! The ball is still going! Where is it going? Okay, guys, this looks like some type of seesaw. Teeter-totter thing. Now, I don't want to jump down because I don't know if I'm going to be able to get back up again. So, I don't want to hit this too hard. If I hit it too hard, it's going to go right off the side. So, I'm thinking we're going to want to crouch in and maybe halfway, maybe a little bit lower than halfway. So, maybe right there, up, over, and in. Oh, yeah, that was perfect. All right, so that was, what? That was hole number 5, wasn't it? Alright, so it is time for hole number 6. What kind of ridiculous stuff has ScrapMan got for us this time? Now look at this, it's the tightrope going to some weird thing I can't really see. I'm not gonna cross all the way over there, so I think what we're gonna do is we're just gonna start blind and we're gonna work our way down this hole. So this is one block wide tightrope. It has to be perfect. We're gonna give it lots of awesome topspin right there. Alright, it's spinning, it's going down the line. It's stopping right here. All right, so we have stopped. Do I understand this right? Am I supposed to just hit it over that? Like over the wall? Is that okay? I have no idea, guys. We're just gonna try this out here, I guess. Let's see, right, like get right underneath it maybe and get right there and hit it like that. It's up, it's down. I don't know, guys. This is getting harder and harder, like exponentially. It doesn't even compare to the last one. All right, so now we're here again. Am I supposed to, like, take it over this, invisible bridge, or is that- that's probably cheesing the level, isn't it? I'm gonna do the same thing, I guess, as last time, and just hope for the best. I mean, there's really not much of a choice, is there? There it goes. Oh my, what a difference. Okay, so you just don't want to be right up against that wall there. This is- whoa, it's going too far. Hold on, it's rolling back. It's rolling back. It's rolling back. And please stop. Okay, it stopped. So let's just kind of give it a small little tap. Roll it up exactly where we need it to be. Okay, it's going up and down again. Please don't come all the way back. Please don't. So we're gonna go full power, full spin, just like that. Up, over, steady out. Uh-oh, it's gone. It's gone. All right, so after a lot of failing on that little tightrope, guys, we are finally back to where we need to be. Now, I hit that way too hard. We wanted to just go up and over one at a time, I think. So I'm gonna go for like a mid shot. somewhere halfway up the ball, maybe a little bit lower, something maybe right about there. So it goes up, it goes over, it's gonna go up and then back again. Stop rolling to the side, please. No confidence, guys. I have no confidence in these shots. Right there. Up and over. Barely. Yes. Stay. Stay. Okay, it's gonna roll back. It's gonna keep centering itself. Yes, that's perfect. That's exactly what I needed right there. All right, so maybe right about here, halfway again. Up, over, into the hole. Okay. Progress, guys. We are making progress. No! It's more of this. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. Let's see what happens here. Just like that. Up. Over. Oh, no, I didn't want it to go over. There's no way it stayed, right? No, it's gone. Now, fortunately for you guys, I can edit out all of this try and try again, so that way we can only see the successful stuff, and it's gonna make me look a little bit better as well. Alright, so we are back down here again. This time I'm not right up against the wall, so I actually have some room to hit lower down here, because I'm thinking I definitely want to just line it up a little short. So let's kind of aim down low right here. Give it the hit. There it is. So it gets a little bit of that backspin, and it slows it right down, and here we are. Uh-oh. Or I guess we're just going to have to hope for the best on this one. Let's kind of line it up here. We're going to hit it there, maybe? Okay, now it's in the line, and it's going to come all the way back, isn't it? Oh, no. But you know what? I feel like, because it's centered, we might be able to actually just kind of hit it. Okay, no, we're back to the beginning. Are you kidding me? I hit the wall, like, right there. Okay. Slowly. Slowly. I'm just gonna hope for the best again here. This is pretty much hope for the best the whole way through, guys. We're gonna go right there, hit it like that. That wasn't even enough. Are you kidding me? Alright, so I learned that you definitely need to give it some power. These slopes are apparently a lot steeper than the ones prior on the other holes. Oh no, this is tough, guys. I can't even line this up center anymore. Now, what I do know is I feel like no matter what, we have to be centered here. I can't just give it all I've got, so I'm just gonna kind of give it super underspin. There it is. It lined up nicely on the little groove, and we are perfectly centered. So I'm thinking now that I know we're pretty much centered, well, hold on here. Is this a jump? Okay, no, it's gonna go up and over. So we're centered pretty well on the line, so I'm thinking I should be able to just line myself up like this, and I'm just gonna give it everything I've got. I don't know, what do you guys think? Here we go. Right up, over, it's going in a straight line. Okay, it's gonna go up and back. Okay, I'm okay with that. I can handle this, because we're gonna kinda just sit pretty right here. It's perfectly lined up. I have some confidence that we are actually going to be able to complete this hole. I'm thinking right about here. Not too high up, just like that. And there it goes. Yes, we did it. Wow, okay, that hole was actually really hard. All right, so now it is time for hole number 7. Here we go. This looks very familiar, guys. Why does it... Ball? Hole, ball. No, we got tricked, guys. This isn't the hole. I think ScrapMan must have wanted you to have a false sense of hope. You know, it's like, oh, this is going to be an easy one. It's literally the first hole all over again. But no, there is actually this ridiculous contraption. Now, what is this? Okay, so we got 4 different balls now, each a different color. There is this ridiculous rotating platform, and we have to hit the balls across over obstacles. Are you kidding me? All right, so it seems like we are going to be starting with the red ball. There's 4 in total. Now, where's the red one? I think it's gonna go blue and then red after, right? Okay, there's the red one. So I want to just be lined up and ready to go for this. So it's going, there it is. Hit it. Was that too hard? Oh, okay, no, wow, okay, it kind of like glues itself in. What the? Okay there's the orange one. Oh, they're orange. Oh, all right, I guess if I was a little quicker, actually, we would have been able to get that right away. Okay, there it is, lining it up. Hit it. Up, over, and in. Okay, perfect. Not too bad. All right, the orange one is lined up. Here comes yellow right there. Oh, I missed. I gotta wait. Remember, guys, golf is a game of patience. It's all about breathing and taking your time. There it is. Hit it. Over the things, and it's going into it. Oh my god, it almost went into the blue one. Jeez, okay. Not so easy, guys. Not so easy at all. We're just gonna wait for the next one right there. Okay, it's up. It's bouncing around. It's in. Wow, I didn't think it was going to make it, but we did make it. And look at this one. What the heck is this supposed to be? This is like pegs in the way. I'm going to center it and line it up right up near the rotating beam. So let's just kind of give it some underspin. There it is. Nice and gentle. Come on, don't roll too far. Wow, okay. Doesn't get better than that. Guys, I have no idea. No idea. All right, here we go. Hit it. What? No way. You gotta be kidding me. We're gonna do this again. Center it. No, you know what? I'm not even happy with that one. I'm not even happy. We're gonna try it again. All right, here we go. I need to go to the left. So we're just gonna hit it that way. There it goes. Now it's rolling just a little to the left. And the reason why I want to do that is because there's pegs and stuff all over the right side. You can see there's more of these little pegs on the right side than the left side. So we're going to aim a little bit more like that on the... Okay, that didn't even matter. All right, the ball is like sitting on the edge right now. Oh no, it's getting picked up by the rotating column. Okay, please stay. Stop. Please stop. All right, there we go. It is not being hit anymore. There is the blue one. And we're just gonna go for pure luck again. Nope. What am I? How is, like, there's no way, guys. There's just no way. All right, so I just took a break. I went to ScrapMan's video to see what the heck he was doing. And this is basically it right here. Something like that. Okay, I was a little late on the draw, but it's basically you have to wait for it to rotate mid-rotation. You can hit it and hope that it rolls through. All right, there we go. Yellow again. Hit it now. It's rolling. Nope. Okay, maybe if I combine what I was doing with what ScrapMan was doing, it might work. So here we go. I'm going to try and we're going to line this up on this right side right here. Okay, maybe that was a little bit too far. Okay, there's the yellow one. And so once it starts rolling over, now it's rolling. Okay, that was absolutely terrible. All right, so now I'm all centered up. We've got the yellow one rotating in, and there's like those white spots, and that's like the clear area. So if we hit it like that, there it goes. Oh, okay, that was really close. We're getting it, guys. We're getting it. All right, there it is, yellow. And right now, yes, yes, please, please. Oh, finally, we did it. We finally did it. Okay, so that means, okay, now there's a ball that has spawned here. And we need to finish, I guess we're just going to go to the normal hole. So that's what it's like. It teases you as if this was a normal, easy hole. And then it really instantly turns out to be a complicated hole that is absolutely ridiculous. But here we go. We're rolling along. Oh, is it going to go in? Go in. Oh, you got to be kidding me. It doesn't even make sense the way it's sitting right now. All right, there we go. We did it. Hole number 7 is done. Alright guys, so this is hole number 8, which means there's only 2 left, this one, and then hole number 9. Now, there's nothing... Okay, wait, there is something behind me. I was like, there's nothing sneaky behind me, is there? Okay, that looks really interesting. Back through the tunnel, though, let's activate this switch. Okay, I've started the challenge. There's nothing here. This is a big jump. Is this a jump? Yes, so that's a big jump. We've got nothing here, something tells me. We gotta go through this tunnel to this weird looking colored area. Okay, we got more color coded balls. Look at this. Okay, whoa. Blue. Yellow. Was that yellow and red? Okay. So I guess we're going to be trying to hit these balls out of the air. So I just saw green and then blue. And then red and then yellow. Is this green? Is this going to be green? It is. Whoa. Oh, come on. Oh, wait. I just got one of the balls out. No, stay. Oh, man. Okay. Okay, maybe if I look up, that'll help. They're coming out so quick. Okay, there's red, and then it's gonna be green, right? Is that gonna be green? Yes. There it is. Oh, come on. Green. Yes? No. Okay, wait, this one's gonna stop. This one actually stopped here, so we can actually finish this one now. So let's line this one up right there. Right there. Perfect. All right, there's green. Done. Right there, yep. Yes. Oh, wow, that barely even rolled. Oh, wow, I thought we were going to get, like, a hole-in-one on the red one. Okay, so we got that one. So now this is going to be yellow next, right? Yeah, there it is. Hit it. Oh, wow, that was almost a one-shot as well. Okay, come on now, stop. Okay, we're going to hit it right there. Right into the ledge. And into the hole. Okay, perfect. And we're going to track it, and we're going to hit it right out of the air. All right, there it is. Boom. Oh, jeez. Caught the lip, and, oh, of course, yep. And there we go. Perfect. Okay, I'm really happy that we did get at least one of those in one try. Now, what the heck? What is this? We're gonna jump and we're gonna wait and right now. There it is. Okay, that wasn't too bad. Here we go, right there. Up, over. Okay, perfect. Okay, this one is like a triangle. Wow, this is really cool. This is like the mini golf gauntlet, guys. This is beyond mini golf. So let's just hit it right over the line. Okay, that one was pretty easy. Orange ball, what's going on here? Ooh, some spinning tops. I'm thinking maybe just another straight at it, right? Yeah, straight at it. Not too bad. Gray. Oh. We got a wave table. I think this is another one that's just straight at it, though. Straight at it and hope for the best. There it goes. All right. Moving along. This is the final ball of the hole here. I definitely want to just line this one up. So let's just give it a little chip shot off the tee there. And it's going to sit right in front of the ramp. Yeah, okay, stop. I'm gonna go full power and see what happens. There it goes, up, over. Oh yeah, that's what I'm talking about, guys. All right, guys, this is it. It's the final hole, hole number 9. What kind of weird shenanigans do we've got going on here? Okay, I can't open that door. What the heck is that? Can we spawn a ball? No, okay, there's no ball here. Where is the ball? This door just opened, okay. What am I doing? Is this moving? Oh, wow, look at that. It's showing you where the hole is. All right, let's see here. Can I just do like a hole in one? Let's try the hole in one challenge here. Boom, like that. It's going straight forward, up and in. We got it, wow, okay, what? That was amazing, we just got it like that. Okay, let's try the same thing with this one. I didn't even know, there was no timing on that, guys. It was just luck. Let's hit it, it's going, it's up. It's stuck. Oh no, this is a bad place. Let's just, we're gonna ditch that one and we're gonna try that one again. Oh my goodness, guys, this is crazy. Come on, get in there. Up, over, in. How is that not in? How is that not in? All right, just count to three, maybe one, two, three, and then hit it. You know, just to kind of throw the timing off a little bit. Up, over, it's going. Yes, we did it. Okay, finally. This side is done. Let's go back to the main area here. Okay, so the left door has opened. Okay, these ones, I think they're easy because if we rely on scrap mechanic physics, it should just go in a straight line to the hole, right? Like that? Nope, apparently not. Okay, now we're going just a little too far left, possibly. Go back to the right, like literally like a pixel. There it is. All right, so that was the best technique right there, guys. Wait, you gotta be kidding me. I have to do it again. Oh my god, I would have just stayed lined up if I knew that. All right, just a little bit to the right. That was one pixel to the right, and it was the pixel that we needed. Now, please don't tell me it's gonna flip over in some other weird way, and we have to do it again. Okay, no. All right, so I guess we're just gonna be doing like a really cool bank shot. You know what? This is actually really cool. I'm just gonna line it up right here like this, and we're gonna see what happens. It goes up, over, around. Okay, that was close. A little bit more. The angle needs to be tighter, just like this, maybe. Oh, wow. So maybe somewhere like that? Ooh, that was really close. How about we switch it up? We're gonna try this one right here. Let's see if it reacts any differently. Wow, it rode the high side of that wall. Okay, I'm thinking we might be able to really cut that gap right there. I feel like we might actually have to cut the gap because it does bounce over it, too. Oh, there we go. What? No way! Okay, I should really be standing here in the exact same spot. But look at this, we can really cut that corner. And that is coming in extremely handy. Okay, now we're cutting the corner a little bit too much. So maybe if we line it up right about here. That's looking good. That's looking good. Oh, okay, no. So let's just bring it back a little bit like that. Up, over, through the cross. And there it is. Okay, yeah, so I got it now. So you definitely don't want to bounce it up too high. You want to keep it low. You want to let it run along the wall. Yeah, all right. I would say this is the final ball. So let's see what we got here. We got this massive rotating thing, and OMG, guys. Look at this. There's literally just one square moment where you can hit it in. I don't even know what the timing is going to be, but I do know that I think I would like to bring the ball up as close to the ramp as possible, maybe, or not as close as possible, but closer. So let's just give it some underspin right there. Let's let the ball creep up nice and gentle. There we go. Now let's see here. I can see the angle. You can see it when it lines up. It's almost like it's flush to the ramp right there. Look at this, guys. You can see, boom, there's like a flushness. I think that's exactly the moment we're going to be waiting for. So we're going to wait for that green side, and then once we see it, there it is, we're going to hit it. Oh, that was almost perfect. Okay, so I need to actually wait for that green side to come all the way around. All right, there's brown. Green is up and over. There it is. In. Oh, wow. So close. All right, so I think I waited a little too long, so we're going to go right now. There it is. It's in. And it went in. It did. It worked. It really, really worked. Can we make this jump? Oh, no. Okay, we can't make that jump. Wow, so there we have it, guys. That is all 9 holes from the Scrap Golf Challenge completed. Now, obviously, guys, this challenge was created by ScrapMan. I'm going to leave a link in the description to his channel. If you don't somehow already know about him, then make sure you go and check it out, guys. This was such a fun challenge, and you guys should definitely try this challenge out for yourself. It's available on the Steam Workshop. And ScrapMan, if you're watching, I had loads of fun with this. Thank you so much for making this challenge. It's really inspiring, and it makes me want to try and create some type of challenge set as well. So guys, if you did enjoy this video, then let me know by hitting that like button. And if you guys want to tune in for some more Endless Scrap Mechanic, then be sure to subscribe to the channel, hop into orbit, and maybe even turn on some notifications so you can get the latest and the craziest coming from me in Scrap Mechanic. So again, guys, thank you so much for tuning in, and I will be seeing you in the next one. So bye for now.